Welcome back to the Pit Stop Tournament Expert Division qualifying round, hole number three. Here we're going to be setting up for a sniper rough bump. APOC 5 plus, sniper 9 plus. However, if you're using a sniper 9, you may want to use a P4 ball. Same thing if you're trying to play this shot with APOC 4. You're probably going to want to use a P4 ball. The adjustment for the drive is P3 plus 10% max, 6 to 7 top spin, 1 left spin. And what I mean by that is if you have 7 top, you can use it. It saves you from having to play any overpower. If you only have 5.8 top, then you'll need to use a little bit of overpower on your drive, even if you don't pull into it. So we're setting up at the top of the plus 11. With spins added, we're gonna have the tip of our ball guide aimed center fairway with spins added. So add your spins first. Here I'm gonna do 6 top spin. It's always 1 left spin. You're either gonna use, 5.8 top spin or 7 top spin, basically. Because if you have more than 5.8, then you have 7, right? So that's what you want it to look like. At the top of the plus 11, have the ball guide, tip of the ball guide centered on the fairway. Adjust P3 plus 10 max. Here's what you need to know about the drive if you're using APOC 4 or 5. Then you will need to add 1 ring of overpower to whatever you pull into, which is basically what I'm playing here, is just before circle break OP. That's right around 1 ring of overpower. I don't have any APOC 4 to do any testing. We're setting up at the top of the plus 11 with APOC 5 plus. So if you're using APOC 4 and a P4 ball, like a 4-4-4 ball, you can definitely play this shot. You'll just have to set up at the top of the 17 instead of the top of the 11. All right? And then play everything else the same. We're looking for 375 to 385 here. Anything in that range. So if you notice yourself coming up short, then add a little bit more OP or add a little bit more topspin if you have it. Whatever the case may be, that's the range you want to be in. That's going to put us in plus yards for our approach shot. The approach shot plays P3 minus 5% at slider. We're always going to use a set spin of 0.3 backspin and 3 left spin always. So you're going to add your spin, and then you're going to set the tip of the ball guide just short of the front of the cup and aimed center cup. You're going to need to favor a slight 1201 on this pull for all wind angles. There are some wind angle tweaks that I have set up for this one to give you a better chance at the drop. When we get these close to straight crosswinds, you know how it can be. Sometimes you'll get a straight crosswind, sometimes you'll get a slight headwind or a slight tailwind, or sometimes it'll be, and like in this case, most of the time it's either been a straight crosswind, a slight tailwind, or a little bit heavier of a tailwind. So that's the three angles that I've seen. I'll go over the it's just minor tweaks to help you get a better chance at a drop. There's a few things that you'll need to pay attention to. Like I said, always point 3 back, 3 left. Add your spin, then set your position just short of the front of the cup, aim center cup. Right? Like that. So this is what you want it to look like every time. We're about, maybe a cup short, aim center cup. Should be in the rough, depending on your drive distance, your yellow ring might be touching up here, or you might be a little bit closer to the bunker but it's not gonna change how the shot plays. What's important is you had the tip of the ball guy looking the same way every time. Make sure that you're pulling this with a slight 1201 favor. And then we've got some wind angles and other tweaks that, listen, if you don't want to try to get the drop every time, then, don't worry about this too much. What I would tell you is play at P3 minus 5, add slider, and then use two clicks of underpower. That would be the base shot, right? Make sure you're still pulling the 1201. However, if we want to get a little more detailed, we're get basically three major wind angles here, and I'm using this rock as my reference. So if you see that there's a dark line that runs up right here, that's kind of the right side. So we got a line going through here, and then our other line, there's a light line on the rock over here. That's what I'm looking at for my second line. So there, right? So we got neutral in the middle, we got tailwind over here, and we got crosswind over here, right? You're going to be in one of those three. If you're in the tailwind, add 0.3 to the adjustment and three clicks of underpower. If you're in the neutral, add 0.2 to the adjustment and use two clicks of underpower. If you're in the crosswind, then there's no change. With that being said, that's if you are set up at the plus 6 or higher, right? Those are the tweaks needed if you're setting up plus 6 or higher, plus 6 yard mark or higher. If you're set up at the plus 5 yard mark or lower, then you need to take that down just a notch, right? So you'll minus 0.1 from the adjustment, but still use the underpower from what I just told you. So points plus 6 or lower in tailwind, you add 0.2 to the adjustment instead of 0.3. If you're in the neutral, you'll add 0.1 to the adjustment instead of 0.2. And in the crosswind, which there's no change if you're set up higher, if you're set up lower in the crosswind, you'll need to minus 0.1 from the adjustment. That's due to let you're getting less wind push when you set up on the bottom side of the plus yards versus setting up on the top side of the plus yards, right? So, I mean, pretty simple stuff. Check your wind angle. You'll either, add 0.2, 0.3, 0.1 to the adjustment or minus 0.1. And then you'll either use no underpower, two clicks or three clicks of underpower. So, I mean, it's not very difficult, even though it kind of sounds like a lot. It's not really a lot. Most importantly, make sure you're pulling a slight 1201. So here I am playing this neutral because I'm just right of that line on the rock that I showed you. So I'm going to add 2 to the adjustment, 0.2 to the adjustment, and play this with two clicks of underpower. And by the way, two clicks of underpower is just having your ball touch the teeth on the top. So you don't want to be into the teeth, you want to be just touching them. Three clicks of underpower, you want to be one click into the teeth, right? So you'll go up, push up until you touch them, and then push up just a click more, okay? That's three clicks of underpower. Two clicks is just touching, three clicks is just in. And it's either that or none. So really, really good opportunity at an albatross, but it is very pull angle dependent. 1201, right? Slight 1201, not a heavy one. And then if you're using these wind angle tweaks that I have, given you, you have a really, really good shot at dropping this one very consistently. So good luck. Hope you get it. And before I leave, I'll give you the plus yard. For those that don't have it, 0 is 70 slider, 1 is 72, 2 is 75, 3 is 77, 4 is 80, plus 5 is 82, plus 6 is 85, plus 7 is 87, plus 8 is 90, plus 9 is 92, 10 is 95, 11 is 97, and 12 is 100. Good luck.